So there's because heaven's a contract, and you can't.
Did you see Connie's daughter?
Yes.
Cheryl?
Yeah. Hello, how are you?
Good. Very good.
I started smoking later on.
Good.
Adam, can notice that this meeting was provided to the Cranford Chronicle, advertised on January 16, 2015. Notification was sent to the Star Ledger and promptly posted on municipal public bulletin board and filed in the office of the municipal clerk, informing the public and time and place according to provisions of the Open Public Meeting Law, Chapter 231, PL 1975. Good evening, everyone. First, we're going to have a presentation by Lieutenant Jim Wright of the Garwood Police Department. Lieutenant, please step forward.
You want me to mic? I do, Lieutenant Jim Wright, W-R-I-G-H-T.
Thank you.
Okay, I had the opportunity to participate in a grant through the Statewide Insurance Fund, which we are members of. And the grant was for any kind of safety equipment or safety initiatives that could help the borough. So we put it for these two defibrillators, and we were awarded the grant, so we got funded. One of them is going to be mounted on the wall in the hallway here, and the other one's going out to the athletic field. And also, I've had the opportunity to talk to Scott Kessler, who I don't believe is here, but he's looking forward to getting the coaches all certified as not only CPR, but in the use of AEDs, so that they'll be able to use them also in case anything happens whenever there's activities down there. So I wanted to present these to the town, and Mayor, here you go. We're going to have them up on the walls as soon as possible.
Thank you very much. Okay, we now have a presentation by Carol Carney, Business and Industry Chamber of Commerce Liaison. Carol, step forward, please.
Can you hear me? Jean just said speak up.
Speak up. I have the same problem, sorry.
May I just step forward, please? My honor to present this check to you from Garwood Box. You're proud to spend any way you choose.
Thank you very much. On behalf of the borough, I accept this check and we probably will put it to good use. Thank you very much.
Sure, hope you will.
Okay.
I have just a few words I need to say.
We're right ahead.
Okay. Excuse me, how much is the check for, man?
That's $1,000.
Thank you. I didn't know if you wanted.
No,
it's okay.
This probably just goes into a general account.
Good evening, Mayor and Council. First, I'd like to thank a few people. It's a little bit past the month of June, but there are a lot of people that weren't around. So I'd just like to thank Chief Underhill for his assistance in making Garwood Rocks a success. Chief Underhill's outstanding administrative planning, the high presence of the police on Garwood Rocks the day itself was kept the event safe. And that is a plus for an event as large as we're running here in town. I'd like to thank Captain Stoker for his assistance with the county vehicle. Fire Chief Carlson, for his assistance, was overwhelming when he brought into town. Christine Mark Antonio, which I don't know if everybody here knows who she is. She's from the county. She is the young lady that handed out over 167 helmets, bike helmets, to your children and adults. And I'd also like to bring in the names of Chris Debbie and Andrew Moran because they facilitated, you know, the program. I'd also like to thank Councilman Martin for his assistance. Assistant Chief Spina for his tireless work to maintain the vendors to make sure they were in compliance with all the fire standards. DPW, the easiest way for me to say with regard to our DPW is the event was over at 5 o'clock. At 7 o'clock, I drove up Center Street and on the side streets, and there was not a paper to be found. Nothing more you can say other than it's excellent. I would also like to thank Christina Ariema and her staff for her assistance. I do have a date for 16, Sunday, June 15th. And hopefully it's on your calendar. Moving on with the Chamber of Court. As of today, we have 35 paid members in the chamber here in Garwood, and there are over 400 members within the five towns that we represent. And that has gone up from 240 to that number, thanking our executive director, Jean Chabadi, who's sitting here. He's brought the chamber to this height. I have Movies Under the Stars, which everyone here knows about, which is September 18th, and the rain date is the 19th. It starts at 7 p.m. and it's free. It's over at the Wise property. Jean, I'd like to turn this over to you now.
Thank you. Thank you, Jill. Yes, on behalf of the Greater Westfield Area Chamber of Commerce, we're very pleased to be able to put on this event here in town. And Carol's done an outstanding job in presenting that for the last 2 years. Next year will be another success. We just have a couple of things. We do have a YEA program, which is the Young Entrepreneurs Academy. It's open for 6th graders through 12th graders in the five towns that we represent, which includes Garwood. And next Monday night at the Westfield Library, we'll be making a presentation about the program. But the students who are interested don't have to just come there. They just call the chamber office to provide them all the information they need. If they want to become a business owner in 30 weeks, that's all it takes for us to take a person, a student who has no business experience, and after 30 weeks they have an up and running business, qualified, legal, and all the rest of that. So we encourage that. We have 24 openings, and that's as many as we can take in one year. The second thing is that we have the Westfield event is coming up just like Garwood Rocks. We have the Westfield Festival, which is September the 27th, and we'll be putting posters out and hoping that residents from Garwood will also come into Westfield and enjoy that event. Other than that, I'm very happy to say that the chamber is growing tremendously. In this borough, we have 4,000 residents roughly, and we have 35 businesses out of the 400 businesses that are in the chambers, which just represents close to 10%. And we're very happy. We hope that we can continue the growth here in Garwood with our chamber. That's all I have
to say.
Thank
you very much. Mr. Goriello?
Yes, Mayor. Just a few things. The DOT work started about a week ago. About 60% or so completed on Hickory Avenue, the drainage. That work will be probably completed by the end of this week, early next week. We will then be moving over to 3rd Avenue between Cedar and Walnut and doing that drainage. Also, the sidewalk bids are prepared and ready to go out. Bids will be received on the 29th of September. Hopefully, the schedule there will be we will award the first week meeting in October. Within 10 days, the contractor should have to start, so we should be doing that work by mid to late October.
Anything else?
That's it.
Mayor, Don, thank you for your memo about the potential 2016 DOT project. Mayor, would this be something that you could refer to Streets and Roads to look at and maybe come back to the council's recommendation?
Please prepare the executive committee and Streets and Roads.
Okay, I will.
Excuse me. Anyone else?
Yes. I have to, Don, I know that these are the streets that you have looked at. Can you also look at the 300 block of Hamlock and let us know how you feel about that.
Okay.
Actually, Mayor, that reminds me, I do have a couple other items on this topic for Don. Don, on the memo, it says that these projects are broken down into roads in need of paving or those where drainage will need to be constructed. And you put that on a couple of the projects, we already did the drainage.
Right.
But on the others, it's hard to tell whether they are just paving or paving and drainage. So
there's always a little bit of drainage because we were required to change catch basin grades, things like that. But there's no extensive drainage on the other projects.
Okay, so Willow Ave, Oak to New Street, and New Street paving south to Rankin, Third Ave, Walnut to Cedar, and West Street, Spruce to Beach is mainly just paving.
Right.
Okay, all right, glad I understand that.
I think there's drainage in most of those streets already, too, by the way.
Okay, and I know in the past we had talked about it, but I think because of the amount of money on the last year's project, we decided to cut back on it. But I know I had mentioned paving behind, or really in front of the DPW recycling yard.
I think that's in 2015.
Is it? Did it actually make it in? All right, let me just double check on that.
Yeah, because we put that in last year, and I believe that was one of the projects you decided to do.
Okay.
But I'll check that.
When we were at the complex that day, I thought you said that it might have not made its way in, so. That's all I have.
That's the right behind, right by the DPW.
Yeah. Thanks.
Anyone else? Hearing none. Mr. Renaud.
Thank you, Mayor. Let's see what we have. I did the residential preferred parking ordinance. That's on the agenda, I guess, for introduction tonight. I think you're going to later on talk about the dumpster ordinance that I also did an ordinance that, I don't know if we're going to discuss this because Bill's not here, that ordinance on maintenance and repair of foreclosed abandoned properties. That was quite a project, candid. So that's ready. And then Bill had also asked me to do ordinance regarding the engineer and planning board engineer, and that ordinance is done, but that's not on the, that I don't think we're going to discuss that tonight. I think ordinance is done. Just a sort of update, I guess, the on the affordable housing litigation. This is the declaratory judgment that we filed. Or I guess you'd call it sort of in lieu of COA. You know that COA is a defunct of the Supreme Court. Basically, as the courts take over, I explained to you that we needed to file a declaratory judgment instead of the old process that we were using with submitting to COA. We did that. That's been filed. We have filed a motion for immunity for a 5-month period while the third round plan, the revised third round plan, I should call it, is being formulated. That's returnable the 18th. Haven't received any opposition yet. Don't know whether I will or not, but that matter is proceeding. Those are the main things. We're also going to have at some point this evening, I don't know whether we're going to do this right now or later, an executive session to discuss a potential litigation or contract matter involving the bulk pickup contract, so we can...
I have a check to do that now.
Mm-hmm. Okay. So that's what I've got for you.
Okay. Any questions of Mr. Renaud?
So two questions. First thing is, so what's basically going on is just all these municipalities all across New Jersey declaratory relief with all these. So just judges all across New Jersey are making these determinations as to, are they hiring anyone, like special masters? Or?
Yes, yes and yes. One judge in each county generally is handling all of them. And each vicinage, I should say, I think there's 16 dissonances, but one in Union County, there's one judge handling, and then there's another judge who's sort of on the bench. That's a poor phrase, I guess, but just, you know, the second string judge for that. That's not a good phrase either. There's two judges that are potentially handling the cases in Union County, but as a general rule, there's one in each vicinage, and yes, special masters are being appointed, and a special master has been appointed in our case.
Okay. And then the other question I have, actually, the hearing that we're going to do about the curbing, the assessment related
yes.
to that, just how does that differ from like usual road work that we do, where you know we may go ahead and rehab a street? This doesn't occur every time. What makes it different than you
as a general rule, and Donald may be able to correct me if I'm wrong, but as a general rule, if there's no curbing, and this is the first time that curbing is being put on, then the people are assessed as opposed to redoing the curbing that they've paid for before.
That's correct. That's the way we've been doing it for all of them.
And do we have any more of these coming? Any more of these?
There's a few blocks that don't have curb.
Not going to be one
right now, but usually what we do is.
I think what the councilman's asking is, do we have any projects that we've done with ordinances that are adopted where there's
no,
any
no,
local
I
assessments?
Sure.
I don't remember any others since this one.
Okay, so that's the answer. Okay, thank you very much.
Okay. At this point, Ms. Ariema, please read Resolution 15-253.1.
Closed session resolution authorizing executive session for the purpose of discussing potential litigation for the Borough of Garwood Equipment Rental Services relating to the contract for user fee-based residential cleanup program of Type 13 solid waste and mass attorney client privilege relating to the above in accordance with NJSA 10-4-12. Closed session meetings open to public exclusion of public subject of matter. It is necessary for the mayor and council of Borough Guard to conduct an executive session close to the public in order to discuss the above listed matters. Now, therefore, be resolved that the council of the Borough Guard hereby moves to the executive session in accordance with the provisions of the Open Public Meetings Act for the purpose of discussing the subject stated above, and be it further resolved that the matters discussed in and minutes of the closed session shall be disclosed to the public when the reasonable confidentiality no longer exists.
May I have a motion to adopt Resolution 15-253.1?
So moved.
Second.
Second.
Roll call, please.
Councilman Martin?
Yes.
Councilman Matthew?
Aye.
Councilman Petrocelli?
Aye.
Councilman Tarantino?
Aye.
And Councilman Fisco?
Aye.
No action will be taken.
There won't be any closed session, so if there is any, we'll be back.